And good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Kettle Moraine Ice Arena for high school hockey here on West Bend Community TV. Along with camera operator Tom Stoff, I'm the Bear, Barry Hirsch. Tonight, the West Bend Ice Bears hockey takes on the Fond du Lac Cardinals. West Bend head coach is Michael Driscoll. Here's our starting lineups tonight. For the visiting Fond du Lac Cardinals, at a forward is number 2, Brett Sable. At the defense, number 5, Logan Groff. A forward is number 10, Keenan Schwartz. At the other forward, number 15, Hunter Parr. The defenseman is number 19, Connor Klepperich. And working between the pipes and goal tonight is a senior, number 31, Garrett Getz. For the Ice Bears, again, a combined co-op team between West Bend East, West Bend West, Germantown, Grafton, and Slinger. It'll start out with Andrew Butler at a forward, Connor Kress at a defenseman, Peyton Fountain at a forward, Andy Rabicki at a defense, Odin Kleba will be at a forward, and Kenny McGaw will be at the goal. As we are set to go here, we are taping this game for you the night before the NFC Championship game. So we want to wish the Packers the best of luck. Face-off, and we're underway here at the Ice Center, Kettle Moraine Arena. Fond du Lac dressed in their road black with the red trim and the Cardinal on their chest with the F. Ice Bears, of course, dressed in the home whites with the black trim. Shot puck coming all the way down behind McGaw, and we'll get a face-off just underway here at the Ice Arena. Talking with cameraman Tom Stoff in our pregame, and we're on a good roll with the Ice Bears. They've only lost one game that we have broadcasted, and that was an overtime loss. So we'll see if we can keep the winning streak alive for the Ice Bears here tonight. Play down in the Ice Bear zone, picked up, puck shot down deeper by Rabicki. And now coming down around along the near boards. Rabicki outside the circle, loses the puck, and here comes the Cardinal. Schwartz picks up the puck, stick handling it down to the zone. Nice pass, oh, wide of the mark though. And here come the Ice Bears right back on the other side of it, but down to pick it up for Fond du Lac is Logan Groff. Puck shot along the near boards. Bears will bring it back down along their side now, try to bring it on to the attack. Just over a minute gone by here in the opening period. Now behind the net, working with the puck, trying to bring on the attack. Here's a slice of the puck. Gonna go all the way down into the zone. Whistle and icing is the call. 15:48 here in the opening period. Faceoff will come into the circle off to the left of goaltender Kenny McGaw. And the draw won by the Ice Bears. Alex Fountain, stick handles the puck, now taken away in the neutral zone. Picked up by the Bears. Here's Lidke with it, now at center ice, puck loose. Coming up with a loose puck now, it's Fountain. Sends it down into the zone, stick handled away by Getz. Puck loose, Fond du Lac comes up with it through the neutral zone at center ice, and the Bears intercept it right away back in the hands of Fountain. Now play right over in the middle, up against the near boards. Here comes the Cardinals with it. Work down behind the net of McGaw. And the puck comes up on the ice in favor of the Bears. But Fond du Lac right there in the neutral zone picking up play of the puck. Now they'll send it back around boards behind their own goaltender. This is Stewart with the puck. Bears trying to keep the zone. They do. Here's a shot. Partial stick block. Bears keeping control of the puck down behind the net, trying to center one out. Wide in the middle of the circle of the punt there is Bublitz. And the Cardinals come away with the puck, loose through the center ice into the neutral zone. Stick handling the puck, coming up with it is Greer. But Greer has the puck taken away from him by the Ice Bears. Comes back all the way down on the other side of the zone, picked up by Klepperich for Fond du Lac. Now it's center ice, dropped back down into the Bears zone. Send it down around the backboards, and it's picked up down there by Johnson for the Bears. Now play continues along the boards, picked up by Sable for Fond du Lac. Sable tries the lead pass quickly up to Schwartz. Schwartz chases it down, stops at the right side circle. Bears there to pick up the puck. Just under 4 minutes gone by now here, 3 minutes gone by, excuse me, in the opening period, and we're scoreless. Now bringing it up into the zone, stick handling the puck for the Bears, it's Johnson. Pushes it down around. Bears keeping the zone down nicely. Now puck coming all the way out of the zone. And McGall will have to come on and make the stick save to bring it back. McGall will have to bring it back around. Now play coming back through down on the other side. As the Bears coming back with it, coming up on the upside. Oh, they lose the back in the zone. And here comes Fondalak now with a quick breakaway down on the left side. Shot off to the side of McGaw. Play continues down around the far side board behind the net as the Cardinals trying to come up. Lichtensteiger though with the puck for the Bears. Now lost the puck. Lichtensteiger tries coming back with it. Play in front of the bench, and now coming up with it on the loose puck, it is a Johnson. He'll set it up, and Getz will make the save, and that'll stop us. 12:33 to go here in the opening period. It's scoreless between West Bend and Fond du Lac here on West Bend Community TV. Faceoff coming to the left of goaltender Getz in the zone. We're going to get a 2-minute minor penalty here called on Fond du Lac.
Cardinals.
It's going to go on Brody Dettert.
Brody Dettert, 2 minutes, roughing.
So the Bears go on the power play here at the 12:18 mark of the opening period in a scoreless game. Chance to pick up a goal here on a power play if possible. Clearing the puck up through the zone, bringing it back up around the other side. No action quite yet on this power play attempt. First one of the night. Butler with the puck back in the zone. Now tries coming out with it. Butler, nice pass up to the front of the ice. Fillion trying to come up with it. And now he'll try centering the puck around the boards to Butler. Butler stick handles the puck. Trying to send it over to Rybicki. Now there's a shot. Oh, just off the mark. There was a save by Butler. 1 minute left in the power play opportunity here for the Bears. Shot up around, up, back up into the net. And whistle to stop play. 11:30 to play here in the period, 56 seconds in the Bears power play, and it's a scoreless first period. Faceoff coming to the left of goaltender Garrett Getz in the circle. Face draw one down there by Fond du Lac. Coming back around, stop, stop, oh, wide over the net. Now coming back around the other side is the Cardinals as they try to come back on the attack. 42 seconds still remaining here in the power play opportunity for the Bears. Stick handling the puck, though, quickly up, and there is Greer. Play continues behind McGaw's net, but now the Bears coming up with it. 32 seconds left in the power advantage. Maybe one more rush at the net here on this power play. Coming up nicely, shot. Oh, pad saved by Getz. 20 seconds left in the power play. Keeping the zone down nicely inside there is Fountain for the Bears. Fond du Lac will ice the puck, however, with 14 seconds left in the power play advantage. And that should just about wipe out this first power play opportunity tonight by the Bears. We're down to 7 seconds in the man advantage. Play continues down along the near boards. And that'll wipe out the power play. Both teams back at full strength. Now Fond du Lac coming up with it. Pack continues into the neutral zone. It's Rybicki for the Bears at center ice. Now Rybicki will pass the puck up forward to Wenzel. Wenzel stick handles it, center of puck, stick save by Getz. Peck of Tins behind the net of Getz now. And here come the Cardinals along the near far boards. Stick handling the puck, coming up closely into the floor zone. Shot, save, up on high, behind the net of McGaw. And the Bears continue playing with it, trying to go. We're scoreless, 10 minutes left here in the opening period. Play at center ice. Picking up the loose puck, coming up with it is Davenport. Davenport can't keep the stick on the handle of the puck. Now at center ice, through the neutral zone. Fond du Lac drops it back down into the zone behind McGaw's net. And Bublitz will come up and pick up the puck for the Bears. Now working it up through heavy traffic, Fountain drops the puck down into the zone. Comes on around to the side of Getz. Center the puck out nicely to Fountain. Fountain couldn't quite get the shot off. Now here comes Fond du Lac back the other way to Greer. And McGaw will make the pad glove save. 9:17 to play here in the opening period, and it's still scoreless between Fond du Lac and West Bend here on West Bend Community TV. Shots on goal so far. Final knockout shooting the Bears by 1-3-2. Now play continues down on the far right side of the circles. Comes along the far boards down in front of the Bears bench. Fonilek tries to keep the zone. Puck loose in the neutral zone. Now push back through. Here's a lead pass coming up to Fountain. Alex chases it down along the far left side. And Fonilek coming up with the loose puck, and they'll try to go back on the attack. Here's Greer in the back of the ice with Fountain. Playing squirrely stick safe with him now. Puck intercepted down there by Wenzel. Brought back down. Here's Fonilek. Potential breakaway. Here's Greer. Shot saved by McGaugh. Oh, Nolan Greer had a breakaway, and McGaugh went down and made the save. And we're still scoreless with 8:27 to play here in the opening period. Faceoff coming to the left of McGaugh in the circle. Net shot, six, save again by McGaugh. Drops it off. Fonilek now with five shots on goal. Two for the Bears at this point. Cardinals trying to keep the zone, but the powers is back, and here comes a race on down to the puck. They'll skate it down into the boards, and the whistle and call it with 8:07 to play here in the opening period. Still scoreless. Face off in the circle to the left of McGaugh. Draw is won by the Bears. Here's Bulas picking it up, bringing it back up the pass. Nice pass, puck up, coming up into the zone. Now working it up through into the zone. It was Lidke. Lidke couldn't quite keep the handle on the puck. Play along the far end, still in the zone, but now coming up to neutral ice and into the zone. Coming up with it is Schwartz. Schwartz stick handles the puck, brings it down along the far side. Now Schwartz handles the puck behind the net. Sends it out to Groff. Groff lost it, had to come back momentarily, pushed it back down into the zone. McGaugh sweeps the puck around, keeps it in play. And here come the Bears back on the attack, but no, almost intercepted out there by Ellingson. Puck kicked around, Ellingson keeps it in play for the Cardinals. Puck comes down around behind the net. Keeps it in play. Brought back down. And now coming up with the puck around through it is Reinicke for Dietert. Now brought back down, comes back and intercepted down there away from the puck is Wenzel. Now Fountain tries keeping it in the zone and it comes all the way back and Ellingson will have to chase it down. 6:45 to play here in the opening period, still scoreless. Puck shot comes loose all the way out of the zone and back down out it comes. And that'll stop us at 6:38 to play here in the opening period. Still a scoreless hockey game between West Bend and Fond du Lac. Faceoff comes in the circle to the right of the goaltender and it comes back in play around. Fond du Lac coming up with the loose puck. Trying to bring it down around and get something going here. Neither team has scored yet. Fond du Lac's outshot the Bears so far in this period, 5-2. Now the Bears trying to work with the puck through the neutral zone. Puck loose at center ice. Drop back down in there by Fond du Lac. McGaugh makes the stick save, keeps it in play. And now they'll continue back at center ice, but Fondy keeps it in play with Murphy. Klapprich now trying to get it, but the puck dropped down inside low by Vorpal for the Bears. 6 minutes to go here in the opening period. Here comes the Cardinals now. Stick handling the puck, bringing it up is Schwartz. Schwartz has the puck, taken away from him, intercepted, and trying to keep it back in play is Butler for the Bears. Butler sweeps it back around behind the net over to Rubicki. Rubicki drops it down inside, back around behind the net, it goes again. Kleba trying to keep possession for the Bears. Now Kleba back out to Kress. Kress sends it back down around. Kleba comes back up with it. Back down in the far left corner. And the tussle and hustle for the puck is on. Puck loose, finally coming out of play. Fond du Lac trying to come up with it, but the Bears keep in control with Rubicki. Now right in front of the net, a little bit of action. Now another shot in front of the net by Fountain. But the save was made by Getz. And play continues with 5 minutes to play here in the opening period, and we're still scoreless. Bears continuing to play it, peppering that puck and keeping it in the zone. Here's Kress trying to keep it down. Action in front of Getz. And they'll whistle and stop that one against the Bears. Faceoff will come into the left side of goaltender McGaugh. In the circle, draw one down there by the Fondelac. They'll take the puck inside. Stick save made by McGaugh. Now along the far boards, and the Fondelac trying to keep it up with it. But here's a potential breakaway. It's getting up with it quickly. It's Pickett. Pickett with a shot. Save made by Getz off of Pickett. And Fondelac coming back quickly the other way. And a whistle going to be called and stopping us at 4:26 to play here in a scoreless first period. Face off to the right side of goaltender Getz. And Fondelac will come up with it to Sable. Sable stick handles the puck up nicely to Parr. Parr jumps it in the zone. Pad save picked away by McGaugh. Fondelac coming right back on it. Shining up, center it. No, out of way. Fondelac doubling up on the Bears now on shots on goal. 6 for the Cardinals, 3 for the Bears. 4:11 to play here in a scoreless first period. Faceoff in the circle on the right side in the neutral zone. Comes back out to the Cardinals. Dietert passes it up to Parr. Parr dumps it down back behind the boards, chased down there by Schwartz. Lichtensteiger in on Schwartz on that, but Schwartz coming away with Lichtensteiger. Now working the puck, sticking it around, centering it. It is Sable. And the save made by McGaugh to stop play with 3:45 remaining here in the opening period. Scoreless between West Bend and Fond du Lac. Face off to the left of McGaugh, draw one by Fond du Lac. Trying to keep pressure on the puck are the Fond du Lac Cardinals. They will, as dropped in by Groff. Puck loose back behind the net, picked up down there by Weber for Fond du Lac. Weber along the near boards in the corner. Trying to keep possession in the corner there for the Cardinals. Finally coming out of there away with it for the Lichtensteiger for the Bears. Lichtensteiger lead pass coming up front to Wenzel. Wenzel stick handles the puck, centers it nicely, but almost out of the reach of Bechta. And the Cardinals come back along with it, back in the zone, it's Greer. 3 minutes remaining here in period number one, no score. Greer, there goes the puck, taken away. Oh, not quite enough room out there and enough angle for Reinicke to get a clear shot on the net. Now a quick breakaway down on the far left side, coming up with it, it's Weber. But the Bears are there to thwart that attack effort. And the puck comes all the way out of the ice and it'll be called with an icing. With 2:33 to go here in a scoreless first period. Face off to the left of goaltender McGaugh. Down in the corner of the zone. And the puck comes out. Cardinals trying to keep the zone. Pressure being applied down there by Rybicki by the Bears. Now Kress keeps the zone, but couldn't quite keep the handle on the puck, and Fondelac will maintain possession. Here is Hefner with a shot. McGaugh with the save. Puck plays off of McGaugh's pad. Play continues. Coming around with it is Sable. Puck coming loop out of the zone. It comes all the way back around behind Getz. They'll wave off the icing call with 1:50 to play in the period. Now along the near boards, back in the zone. Fondelac drops it up in front of their bench. Bears come up, keep it up into the play of Fountain. Now Fountain kick handle the puck along the far back board, tries pacing it back over to Bublitz. Bublitz loses the puck, comes all the way out of the zone. And Rybicki will chase it down, but they'll whistle it off for icing. 1:26 left here in the opening period, still scoreless between the West Bend Ice Bears and the Fond du Lac Cardinals. Faceoff coming to the left of goaltender Getz in the circle. Fond du Lac wins the draw. They'll have the puck. Push it back around and trying to come up with the loose puck. Now they do. Pick it up at center ice and coming down inside. It's Weber. Weber's still with the puck now, losing it now, trying to foul it up to Graf. Graf fouls one across off the right side of the net. Weber down there to chase it. Gives way to Schwartz. Now puck loose, picked up by Fondalak. Under a minute to play in the period. Shot in a goal! Fondalak with the goal, the first one of the night. At the 16:05 mark of the opening period, Fondalak gets the first goal of the night. And it's 1-0 Cardinals. Now off the faceoff. Fondalak will work with it with the 1-0 lead as we draw close to the end of the first period.
Cardinal goal is Morgan R20, Paul Breyer. Assist number 4, Aiden Schwartz. Number 19, Connor Cupper.
So they give the goal to Nolan Greyer at the 16:05 mark, and it's 1-0 Fondalak as we draw to the end of the first period now. And Fondalak will just stick handle the puck and work it down to end the period. Take it into the locker room, but now a quick pass off ice intended for Sable. Sable goes down. Final 10 seconds here in the opening period. A late first period goal by Fondalak. Gonna send them into the locker room with a 1-0 lead. And that'll be the end of the first period. Shots on goal in the first period for Fondalak. They get 9. For the Bears, they get 3. Only one goal here in the first period, and it came late at the 16:05 mark. Nolan Greyer with the goal, and Fondalak will lead it 1-0 after the first period. Second period coming up next after this break here on West Bend Community TV. Back here at the Kettle Moraine Ice Arena for period number 2 between West Bend and Fondalak with camera operator Tom Stoff. I'm the Bear Barry Hirsch. 1-0 Fondalak with the lead on a late first period goal at the 16:05 mark. Nolan Greyer had the goal. So here we go, second period underway. Teams will switch ends of the ice, and now the Bears will be skating left to right towards the goal here in the second period. Fondalak will shoot down at the far left goal as you're watching this replay game. Bears coming out with it. Only one minor penalty in that entire first period, as there's a shot and a stick save was made by Getz. Another reason why we had such a very fast-paced first period. Now we're going to get a penalty called on Fondalak, as the Bears were going to try to get an extra attacker on the ice, but Fondalak touched the puck just in time before McGaugh could get out of the ice and get an extra attacker out there on the ice. So the Bears will go on the power play, their second opportunity of the night. They're 0-for-1 on power plays. They had one in the first period. This will be another 2-minute minor. This one's going to go against number 19, Connor Klapperich. So here we go, power play opportunity for the Bears.
2 minutes, Ruffy.
Try to tie this thing up now on the power play man advantage. And instead it's gonna go the other way. Here's Sable coming, one-on-one, shot, ho, high! Over the net of McGaugh. Not exactly the way you want to start a power play if you are the Bears. Now here come the Bears on the attack, bringing it up into the front side of the ice. Pickett has the puck stolen away again by the Cardinals, and chasing it down is Sable, but he'll get out chased down there by Fountain for the Bears. Fountain works behind the net. 1:09 remaining in the man advantage, and the Bears have yet to get a good charge on the net. Now they'll try setting it up the attack again. Here is Rybicki. Rybicki skates in on the right side, tries centering the puck, comes loose out of the right side, and it comes back down around the line to Lipke. Lipke coming around, and now Fondalak Greyer will ice the puck down to the other side. 47 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Still 1-0 in favor of Fondalak. Bears have yet to get a good shot on goal here on this power play opportunity. Try it again. Here's Butler skating in on the zone. Butler left side, skates in around the ice. Now takes it down on the right side. Outside the circle. Trying to center. Oh, puck missed. It's Mark Tolley comes out of the zone. And now picked up a loose puck at Schwartz for the Cardinals. Schwartz to Kendall. Schwartz shot up high over the net of McGaugh. 15 seconds left in the man advantage. Bears one final shot at it on this power play as it comes inside the blue line. Whistle stops us. 14:26 to play, second period. 10 seconds in the power play advantage. And Fondelec still with the 1-0 lead. Faceoff coming in the circle, right side in the neutral zone. Draw one initially by the Bears. Now puck tied up along the boards. Coming up with the loose puck at Schwartz for Fondelec. He'll skip it away. And that'll burn up the power play, and both teams back at full strength. So West Bend, again, will miss the power play opportunity. And the Bears now 0 for 2 tonight on power plays. Puck comes loose all the way down to the other side. A little over 2 minutes have gone by here in this second period. Chase down to the other side and a whistle will stop us. Final echo change up lines here as we get set to go. Faceoff coming to the right side of McGaugh. Draw one by the Bears. Sick hand of the puck, bringing it up ice. Shot off the backboard. Drop back down and play by Graw for the Cardinals. Now puck comes loose out of the zone and all the way back down, coming back by goaltender McGaugh. Kressel chases it down. Each team now with one shot on goal here in this early goings in the second period. Fondelec still though out shooting the Bears at this point, 10-4. Draw one by the Fondelec Cardinals. Here is a stick kind of the puck up the ice to Schwartz, but in front of the Cardinals bench. Schwartz loses the puck, comes loose at center ice. Skates all the way across to the near boards right underneath our vantage point. Kress will drop it back down to the zone for the Bears. Now picked up, loose puck coming in, shot, trying to save, no. Had a man inside the zone, couldn't come up with it. Bears looking a little bit more aggressive here in the second period at the outset. Drop it back down inside the zone. Picked up, tapped around. And coming loose was it Ellingson who wanted the puck, and Ellingson gets tripped up. And that's going to cost, I believe, the Bears their first minor penalty of the night. As Andy Rebecki will go to the box for a two-minute minor. Faceoff coming to the right of goaltender McGaugh. So Fondelec's first power play of the night. We'll see what happens. Sable, and there is the puck iced all the way outside down to the other side of the zone, all behind Getz. And the Cardinals will come back and chase it and reset up the attack. They are on the man advantage, their first power play of the night. They lead in the game 1-0. Puck comes along the near boards, it's Hefner. Now pushed back, and Graf will chase it back down behind Getz. Minute 20 to go in the man advantage for the Cardinals. Puck taken away down there by Anderson. Anderson now works with Fountain for the Bears. Oh, here's a center, and it could have almost shot one there, but it was out of the reach in the grass. Now Fondelec coming back up with it. Hefner keeps the zone for the Cardinals. Coming up around, Hefner comes it back. Now Sable with it. Takes it cross ice over to Graf. Graf punches the puck over to Parr. 40 seconds remaining in the final, like man advantage. Shot, wow, slapped by Greer. Off the back glass behind McGaugh. And with 30 seconds to play in the man advantage power play, here comes Fondelec trying to keep the zone. Parr drops down in front of the for Cardinals bench. 22 seconds remaining in the man advantage for the Cardinals. Under 11 to play in the period. Now the puck comes loose out of the zone, and with 10 seconds, Fanalek maybe will have one final rush on it. Here's Weber, passing the puck up. Drill, drop nicely in front of the bench by Fountain. Shot high over the glass of McGaugh. So as they sort things out, we'll get set for the faceoff, which will come down in the Cardinals' zone. To the right of goaltender McGaugh in the circle. Draw one, Sable has it inside the blue line. Tries pushing it back. Bears will try to skate this one out, and here's a possible potential breakaway coming up strong as Johnson with his shot. Missed the goal. Whistle. And we're gonna get a Fond du Lac penalty now. Sable goes to the box for a slashing penalty at the 10-20 mark. So we'll skate even for the next 2 minutes, and then it'll be about a 2.5 minute power play still available for Fond du Lac. Now here is Greer on the left side, skating in, shot wide of the mark off McGaugh. Greer still sticking on the puck, now loses it. 7 minutes have gone by here in period number two. Still a 1-0 game in favor of the Fond du Lac Cardinals. Now here come the Bears coming back up left to right as they skate with it up to the puck. It's Crest handling with it. Crest loses the puck as it comes back loose. And Rybicki will pick it up. Rybicki pass up to Crest. Crest at center ice through the neutral zone. Almost lost the puck. He does lose the puck. Now skating with it is Schwartz in on the left side. Schwartz with a nice move. Tried sweeping it around and couldn't. And there's a puck shot all the way down behind Garrett Getz. But because we're skating at even strength, it'll be an icing call. 103 remaining in the Fond du Lac minor. 346 remaining in the 5 minute minor to Fountain. And 9:24 remaining in the period. So again, in another minute, Fond du Lac will have a minute 40 of a power play opportunity. Shot, whoa, missed the mark, or we could have been tied at one. Faceoff getting ready to come to the right of goaltender Getz in the circle. Fountain comes in for the faceoff. He'll lose the draw. And the Cardinals will come up with it. Puck drop back down behind the net of Getz. Now up ice, Davenport has it. Lost it. Bublitz comes back with it. Klapperich tried coming up with it for the Cardinals. Klapperich gives way. Weber comes up with a loose puck. Weber stick handles the puck, tries centering it in. Comes away with it, nothing there. Here come the Bears back. Fountain drops it down behind. Bears with a quick line change up here now. 8:25 in the second period. Still 1-0 Fond du Lac. And Fond du Lac's minor is over. So they have a man advantage power play now for the next 2:35. Bears will try to skate out of it and still only be down 1-0 at the worst. Play continuing up around inside the circle. Hefner tries stick handling the puck back around the right side. Hefner comes up behind the net. Now looking for someone to get it to. Hefner still looking. Hefner tries centering it. Out over, out on the point to Greer. Down low right side to Parr behind the goal. Back out to Greer. Now left-handed, oh, just out of the grasp of Sable. Hefner coming, trying to save the puck. Minute 50 remaining in the man advantage for Fond du Lac. 7:27 to play in the period. Faceoff coming in the circle to the left of goaltender McGaugh. Draw one by Fond du Lac. They'll keep the zone. Here's Sable with a shot off the boards. Minute 40 remaining in the Fond du Lac power play. Greer with a shot and the save made by McGaugh. 7:14 to play second period. Still 1-0 Fond du Lac. Here's the draw, one by Fond du Lac. Sable. Now working along the near board. Puck comes loose out of the zone. All the way back down. Chases on. Hefner comes up with it. Slams himself into the boards. Comes up behind to Greer. Now here come the Cardinals. Skating right to left. Stick handling the puck up ice. It's Greer. Greer inside the zone. Greer skates in on the right side circle. Back behind the net is Greer. Greer coming in. Chased back there by Rybicki again to the boards. Now Greer trying to get some help from Parr. Rybicki still in on the power. Rybicki slams him into the board. Puck comes back out. Here's Sable with a shot. Pad save made by McGaugh. Still 45 seconds to go in the power play here for Fond du Lac, but that'll burn up some of that time as the puck is iced all the way down to the other side. Here comes Fond du Lac again. Sable skates in inside the zone for the Cardinals. Sable skates in left side, now behind the net. Sable still sticking on the puck. Sends it out to Hefner. Hefner back to Sable. 6 minutes remaining, 20 seconds left in the power play advantage for Fond du Lac. Puck loose. We're down to 15 seconds in the power play. Hard slam into the boards, down back behind the net. And that'll whistle and stop play with 5:45 to go in the second period. And we're going to get a penalty called on the Bears. So Fond du Lac will go on another power play opportunity. They'll have a very, very brief two-man advantage. They'll skate 5-on-3 for 8 seconds. Then the minor penalty to Fountain will be over and it'll be 5-on-4. All right, so the Fountain penalty is over. So Fond du Lac now 0-2 on power plays, but they're on another one now for a minute 45. 5:25 to play here in the second period. Cardinals lead the Bears 1-0. Schwartz to Kales behind the net. Over to Weber. Puck loose in the circle in the zone and trying to keep the zone. Bears come up with a loose puck. Slap it down in behind the net of Getz. Skating in hard, but Cardinals coming up with the loose puck. Here's Dietert to Kales the puck. Dietert up at center ice. Now skates it through the neutral zone. Dropped down nicely on a check by Lidke. Lidke coming up, shot by Lidke, stick save made by Getz and sends it out of bounds. Teams will switch lines here, 4:47 to play second period. Still 1:01 to go in the penalty to Butler. As Fond du Lac holding on to a 1-0 lead. Shot, slap, save made by Getz. Only goal so far came late in the first period. Nolan Greer for Fond du Lac slapped one in at the 16:05 mark. Fond du Lac now again doubling up on shots on goal against West Bend, outshooting the Bears 12-6 at this point. Down to 4.5 minutes to play here in the second period. Still 1-0 Fond du Lac. Here's Sable inside the blue line. Now stick handles the puck, centers it nicely to Parr, and his shot is saved by McGaugh. Face off to the right side of McGaugh in the circle. Draw one by the Bears. Skating out with it, coming up with a loose puck, it's Kleba. Kleba down on the right side, skates off behind the net very fiercely. Kleba stick handles the puck inside the circle. And now Klebe will lose the puck as the Cardinals come up with the puck. Here's Parr. Parr stops inside the neutral zone. Stick handles it, passes it upside to Greer. Greer with the shot. Save made away there by McGaugh. And that's going to end the power play for Fond du Lac. So Fond du Lac now 0-3 on power play opportunities. They had a back-to-back power play now. And both teams back at full strength with 3.5 minutes to play here in the second period. Shot, oh boy, over McGaugh, but it does not go anywhere. And play will continue along the far boards. Vorpal gives way over to Klebe. Klebe takes care of the loose puck. Now the Cardinals are going to have a penalty called against them as McGaugh will come off the ice and they will stop the play as it is finally touched by Dietert. With 3:11 to play here in the second period, Fond du Lac 1, West Bend nothing. This is high school hockey on West Bend Community TV. Faceoff coming down to the left side of circle of Getz.
Cardinal penalty to number 15, Hunter Parr, 2 minutes, interference.
Parr interference call, Black action in front of the net. As the Bears will go on their third power play opportunity of the night, trailing 1-0, try to get an equalizer now. Lichtensteiger stick handle it down on the right circle. Sends it around, shot by Fountain. Lichtensteiger tried keeping the zone. And the Bears will have to come back and reset it up. Here's Fountain, lost it momentarily, now gets it back over to Lichtensteiger. 2:35 in the period, minute 24 in the Bears power play. Getting up and back and around. Back down behind the net, looking to set something up and get maybe a decisive tying goal. Shot up, no, off the pipe. Top back again, down save gets. So a couple of good quick opportunities there by the Bears, unable to capitalize on it. As we go under a minute to play in the power play and 2 minutes to go here in the second period. Drop back down, Fond du Lac coaching staff screaming they want the icing call on the Bears. As we'll get a stoppage in play with 1:54 to go in the second period and 44 seconds remaining on the man advantage for the Bears. Faceoff coming in the net to the left side of McGaugh. 40 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Puck along the near boards, now picked up and handled down there by Leakey. Slammed into the boards, picked up at center ice by Greer for the Cardinals. 22 seconds remaining in the man advantage for the Bears. Had a couple of brief shots, but nothing since then. Penalty killing unit out here for the Cardinals have done a good job as the Bears now have 10 seconds left on the man advantage. Trying to get something going, but it doesn't look like it's going to prosper here in this play as the Bears will lose that one, and the Bears are now 0-3 on power plays tonight. So neither team allowed a chance to score on power plays here in the second period. It's still 1-0 as we have 1 minute remaining in the period. Bears trying to get the tying goal, puck up along back behind the board. Play continues inside the zone. Davenport drops it back around behind the net. Still trying to come up with it. 35 seconds to play here in the period. Shot made and a save by Getz. Bublitz has a slap shot from inside the circle, but Getz was there to make the glove save. Thirty-four seconds to play in the period. Nobody has scored in this period. So it should be an exciting third period and a one-goal differential at this point. Shot, pad save by Getz, kicks it out away, keeps it in play. Down to 25 seconds to play in the period. Back and around and coming up with it, it's Sable for the Cardinals. Sable loses it at center ice. tipped around inside, and whistle will stop us with 11 seconds to go in the period. Puck drop won by the Cardinals with 8 seconds. Puck shot deck around behind the net, and that's going to bring us down to the end of the second period. So it'll still be a 1-0 game in favor of Fond du Lac after the second period. Shots on goal here in the second period for the West Bend Bears, 6, giving them a 2-period total of 9. And for Fond du Lac, 5 shots on goal, giving them a 2-period total of 14. So after 2 periods of play, the score remains. The Fond du Lac Cardinals 1 and the West Bend Ice Bears 0. Third period coming up after this break here on West Bend Community TV. And we are back here at the Kettle Moraine Ice Arena for the third period tonight. West Bend trailing Fond du Lac 1-0. With camera operator Tom Stoff, I'm the Bear Barry Hirsch. No scoring in the second period. The only game scoring right now back in the first period was Nolan Greer at the 16:05 mark for the Cardinals. So we skate now at the start of the third period. Both teams are at full strength. And the Bears need 1 goal to tie, 2 to win. Fond du Lac will look for a victory on the road. Would be a good one here. Here's a slide shot off to the right side of Getz. Now in front, shot stopped there by Poulton. Safe stick made by Getz. Play continues. First shot on goal for either team there comes here in the third period. Fond du Lac still out shooting now the Bears, 14-10. Sliding a shot puck in, offside called at the blue line. Right near the Bears bench. And here's a potential 2-on-1 breakaway now for the Bears. Shot, whoa, wide around Pickett. Couldn't come up with it. Pickett now trying to come back. Pickett with a stop. Pickett again, and Pickett again. Oh, a couple of good opportunities there by Chase Pickett for the Bears. Couldn't bring it home for the goal. Back the other way quickly comes Greer for Fond du Lac. Back behind the net. Face it up, chop it in. McGaugh goes down for the save. Play continues behind McGaugh's net. And now puck picked up loose by Litke. Litke comes in, shot, stick save by Getz, kips it away. Here's Greer. Passes the puck up by Sue Weber. Weber along the boards, passes intercepted out there, however, by Wenzel for the Bears. Wenzel stick handles the puck through neutral zone at center ice. Now right behind us, crash into the boards. 2 minutes gone by here in this third period, still 1-0 Fond du Lac. Punch in, Fountain keeps the zone. Puck comes out loose and picked up out there by Greer. Here inside the circle, shot save made by McGaugh. Fourteen and a half minutes to go here in the game. It's still Fond du Lac 1 and West Bend 0. Shots on goal now, 15 for the Cardinals, 11 for the Bears. Back down behind the net, Fountain has it. Lost the puck momentarily, now trying to keep its zone in play. Fountain comes up with the puck along the far board, over to Kleba. And the Cardinals come up with it. Oh, there was a chance for a pass up to Parr, off of Parr's stick out of his grasp. And now the Bears coming up with it at center ice. Puck loose in the neutral zone. Fountain tries coming up with it in front of the bench of Fountain to Fillion. Under 14 to play now. Shot made, a save off of Fountains by Getz. Kept in by Rybicki. Now play continues along the near board, just down to the left inside of the zone. Coming out with the loose puck, it is Klapperich. Skating around, shot, save, got the pad of gets. Another one off the pad of gets. So Rybicki coming in strong for the Bears, peppering Rybicki and gets, but not able to push one in. Face off to the right of gets. Bears win the draw. Take it around, try to keep the zone in nicely by Johnson. Stick handling the puck, trying to bring it around, and tapped around by Rybicki, but he'll lose the puck. Coming up on the far right side, it's Greer along the far boards. Puck skips out loose, coming all the way back down inside the zone. The chase is on. Hefner will come up with it for the Cardinals. He's taken out of the play, however. Shot continues to play behind, gets his net. Tapped up, around. Here's Parr. Lidke tried keeping it inside. Now the loose puck comes out. Kress is going to give chase, going up against Greer, and they come off the way with it. Cardinals keeping the zone. Look out. Pressuring. Shot. Save made by McGaugh. Another shot going off wide of McGaugh. But the Cardinals keep the pressure and keep the puck. Here's Groff. Lead pass up to Klapperich. Klapperich down, stick save, and holding it off is McGaugh. Stopping us with 12-11 to play in the period. Still 1-0 Fond du Lac here on West Bend Community TV. Puck comes loose all the way outside the zone and going to be chased down on there by Wenzel for the Bears. Wenzel comes up with the loose puck now, try to keep the zone for the Bears. But Fond du Lac thwarts it again, up tried to Schwartz. Schwartz inside the blue line, skates it down there. Now goes out into the right side corner. Schwartz still comes up with the puck behind the net, tries centering it. Wiped away by McGaugh, heavy pressure in front of McGaugh, but he cups it away again. And here come the Bears back out on it. Now potential breakaway coming up here for the Bears. Getting with it is Reinicke. Puck comes up way over behind the net of Getz. And here comes Fond du Lac back on with the attack now. Stick handling the puck, bringing it up inside the front zone. It's Sable. Leaves way to the puck, and here come the Bears. Coming back with it is Butler. Butler stick handles the puck inside the blue line. Takes it back down behind the net. 6 minutes gone by here in the third and final period. Still 1-0 Fond du Lac. Only goal of the game at the 16:05 mark in the first period. Nolan Greer for Fond du Lac. And that's all we've had in goals. Bears trying to get at least a tying goal here in this third period and force overtime. Plenty of time remaining. 10:39. Shot around, oh, missed by Kress. Getz has got a lot of saves, 15 of them here tonight so far. Now Greer comes up with a loose puck for the Cardinals, but he skates away and loses it to Fountain. And whistle inside the blue line stops us with 10:21 remaining. 1-0 Fond du Lac with the lead over West Bend. Faceoff draw won by the Bears. But Fond du Lac comes back up away with it to Weber. Weber passes the puck around inside the lens. Whistle at the blue line, stopping us with 10:11 remaining. Face off at the circle inside the blue line. Draw one by the Bears. Rybicki tried chasing it down. Rybicki gives way, and now coming up with it is Pickett. Pickett stick handles the puck through the neutral zone at center ice, loses the puck in front of the bench. Pickett still trying to keep it, but now the Bears able to come up with the loose puck and keep it in play. Chased down inside low by Johnson. He'll lose possession of the puck. Fond du Lac coming up with the loose puck. At center ice, now back into the neutral zone and send it back down into the Bears zone. Weber picks up the loose puck for the Cardinals. 9:35 remaining. Bears trying to stage a comeback here, only trailing it by one. Butler down, and so is Kress. Yes, sir. Come on. Contact, sir. And the Bears are going to get to go on a power play now. as a minor penalty going to be called on number 20, Nolan Greer, for Fond du Lac. So an opportunity here now for the Ice Bears with 9:25 to play in the game, trailing 1-0, but a 2-minute power play advantage now. Cardinals will ice the puck and make the Bears come back and retrieve it and reset up the attack. We're on 9 minutes to go in the game and 1:40 in the power play. Here come the Bears now on the attack, setting it up, centering it up inside the Fountain. Fountain with a shot. No, it was not there. Play behind the net of Getz. Trying to come back. Here's Fountain now. Fountain shot left side, misses the mark. Back over the left side, Davenport. Loses the penalty puck immediately. Now keeping inside the zone. Drop back down, and the save made by Getz. He'll keep it in play. And the Cardinals will ice the puck all the way back down, and McGaugh will have to put it back in play. 8:32 to play in the period. 1:05 to go with the man advantage. Here's Butler losing the puck at mid-ice. Now giving way to Kleba. And the zone being kept in as Butler loses it. Now Butler gives way into Fountain. Fountain tries dropping it down. 52 seconds remaining in the power play. 8:14 in the period. Back down. Oh, couldn't quite get Fountain on it in time. Cardinals will drop the puck and ice it, and they'll quickly change up lines now with 8 minutes to play in the period and 35 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Shot, puck, and stop by Getz. Along with camera operator Tom Stoff, I'm the Bear Barry Hirsch. 7:53 remaining here in the third period at the Kettle Moraine Ice Arena. And the West Bend Ice Bears trail the Fond du Lac Cardinals 1-0. Only one goal in this period back at the 16:05 mark of period number one. Nolan Greer for the Cardinals. 14 seconds remaining on the man advantage for the Bears. And that's going to wind up the power play. So the Bears are now 0-4 tonight on power play opportunities. Score remains 1-0. 7:20 to play in the period. Shot well wide of the mark from McGaugh. Play continuing down around the far right side. Getting a little scrappy now as it, oh, in the crease, and the shot was not there for Schwartz. Greer back inside the blue line in front of the bench of the Bears. Puck comes loose all the way back down, and they'll whistle the icing call. Starting to run out of time now. Clock starting to run against the Ice Bears. We're down to 6:52 remaining. Bears now have outshot Fond du Lac 19-16, but trail on the scoreboard 1-0. From the faceoff, play continues. Bears working on it behind the net. Davenport tries coming up with the puck. Davenport works it around, trying to come up with it as Wenzel. Still staying down there in that Fond du Lac zone, however. Now the puck comes loose out of the zone, and the Bears try setting up the attack to Wenzel. Through center ice, now through back into the zone. Here's Betcha coming up with it along the near boards. Back down along, and the puck comes loose all the way out. McGaugh makes the stick save, keeps the puck back in play. Work it around, 6:10 remaining in the game. Bears try to tie this game up at this point and possibly force overtime. Only down 1-0. But the Fond du Lac defense here on the road tonight doing a great job. Hefner pushes the puck back through the zone, through the neutral ice. Coming up with those puckets, Murphy now. And he'll lose the puck away to Eckert for the Bears. Skate down in front of the neutral zone. It's Kress right below us. 5.5 minutes to play in the game. Still 1-0 Fond du Lac. Play continues down inside the zone. Intercepted down there by Butler. Try centering the pass to Fountain. Couldn't go any. Oh, there's another one. Short side of Getz. Skate down in the far right corner. Shot back down, misses the mark by Rebecki. Rebecki tries keeping the zone at the point, but can't quite hold on to the puck. Now up through center ice and back into the neutral zone, and coming back the other way again come the Bears. Here's Rebecki. Stick handles the puck. Rebecki tries dropping one around the other side. Back on the far right side, slapped by Kress. Intercepted, now taken right back down there by Kress. Over to Butler. Butler takes it down around the left side of the circle to Fountain. Fountain, Butler, shot, goal! And we are tied! A tying goal for West Bend at the 12:27 mark. And it's 1-1. And now the faceoff in a brand new hockey game at 1-1. So Kleba gets the goal to tie things up. Lichtensteiger with the assist. At the 12:27 mark, and it's 1-1. Now the Bears can skate for the possible win here tonight. 3:50 to play in regulation now, we're gonna say, because we're tied at one. So the Bears break the door open finally at the 12:27 mark, and we're tied at one. Now maybe a little bit of momentum on the Bears bench. Fond du Lac now will skate back in a new game. Try to get the, at this point on the road, force the overtime. But the Bears at home would love to get another goal and win this in regulation. Bears have now outshot Fond du Lac 20-17. So they've outshot Fond du Lac right now 11-3 in this period. Skate around, try to center the puck, shot! Oh, save made by Getz. Bears keep the pressure on the puck though, Wetz will have it. We're coming down on 3 minutes to play here in the regulation. 1-1. Puck loose, trying to come up. Bears try keeping the zone. Cardinals trying to get it back themselves. And they will get it back. Here's Murphy skating up with the puck. Gives it to Klapperich. Shot, up, save! Made in by McGaugh. 2:46 to go here in regulation. 1-1 between Fond du Lac and West Bend. Play now back behind the net, shot, oh, McGaugh almost lost it. Play behind the net of McGaugh. Schwartz trying to keep the zone for the Cardinals. 2:20 remaining. Puck comes loose all the way on the other side. And we'll get a line change by both teams here prior to the next faceoff. In the circle, just to the left of goaltender McGaugh. Trying to skate up and around with it. Bears trying to get something here going. Coming up on 2 minutes to play in regulation. Now the coaches will start a chess match here in a moment and see which team might possibly pull their goalie for that extra attacker on the ice. Cardinals trying to keep it, stick loose. Slammed into the backboards, minute 30 to play in regulation, still tied at one. If you're the Bears now, you don't want to give up a last second goal like you did in that first period, because that would be the game at this point. puck loose all the way outside, back into the zone, and they'll whistle at stoppage. With a minute 16 remaining in regulation, tied at one. Face off to the left of goaltender McGaugh, or to the right of goaltender McGaugh in the circle. And the draw won by the Bears with a minute 13 to go in regulation. Final act now will try and attack it with Greer. Greer comes through center ice, now into the neutral zone. Greer stick handles the puck, takes it down inside the right circle. Slammed inside the board, look out! And that's gonna cost the Bears with 55 seconds remaining in regulation. So a 2 minute minor taken by Davenport. And now Fond du Lac will get the man advantage with 55 seconds remaining. And Ryan Sarazen, the head coach of the Fond du Lac Cardinals, takes his 1 minute allotted timeout now to set up what could be a decisive and finishing goal with the power play advantage and 55 seconds remaining. Bears will try to skate through it and take it into overtime. Fond du Lac Cardinal fans that made the trip over here tonight trying to cheer their boys on. 55 seconds remaining, they got a man advantage. Bears will try to skate out of this one, and there's one good one right there as the puck comes all the way down out of the zone. Chased down there by Fountain. 42 seconds left in regulation. Shot save made by Getz. So we're down to 39 seconds remaining. 5-on-4 in favor of the Cardinals. Face-off draw continues to be held by the Bears. But now here come the Cardinals back the other way with 30 seconds remaining. Skating back around through it, here's Hefner in front of the bench, 22 seconds remaining. Look out, here comes Groff. Can't get it in, 18 seconds remaining. They'll slap one shot, saved by McGaugh. And the puck comes out of the zone all the way with 12 seconds remaining. So it looks like we are gonna go to overtime here tonight at the Kettle Moraine Ice Arena, as the Bears get a tying goal here in this third period, and they will force it into overtime. One goal in the period at the 12:27 mark. Kleba assisted by Lichtensteiger to tie this game up. Shots on goal here in the third period. The Bears, their best shots on goal period with 12 for a three-period total of 21. Fond du Lac was held to just five shots on goal in that third period for a total game of 19. So we're going to overtime, tied 1-1 here on West Bend Community TV. Back here at the Kettle Moraine Ice Arena, we go to overtime, eight-minute period, 1-1. Fond du Lac will still have a minute 5 in their power play advantage. So here we go into the overtime session. It's Sable with a shot, misses the mark. Back down behind the net, trying to keep things under pressure and under goal, and taken up on there by Sable. Pushes it out to Hefner. Hefner over to Greer. Greer, shot, saved by McGaugh off the pad. They'll continue play. 30 seconds to go in the power play advantage. Here's Sable, they'll try peppering it again over to Greer. Shot missed, down to 25 seconds in the man advantage. And 7:17 to play here in overtime. Bears tied this game up at the 12:27 mark of the third period on the Kleba goal, assisted by Lichtensteiger. Now here comes the Cardinals with Greer. Greer out of the zone, sticking the puck through center ice. Now through the zone and brings it down into the attack zone. Greer shot off the pipe of McGaugh. McGaugh with another quick save and it goes back up into the netting. 2 seconds left in the final act, man advantage. 6:57 remaining in the overtime. Final act will go 0 for 4 on power plays. So both teams now 0-4 on power plays tonight. We're in an 8-minute overtime session. We're down to 6:46. Shots on goal. Bears 21-20 against Final X. Faceoff coming in the right side of goaltender McGaugh. Checking into the boards has picked up a little bit now here in this overtime session. Cardinals have Sable up against the far board. Lichtensteiger in on the play to try to get it going. Taken back around, but finally pushes it back. Keeping around at Schwartz. Back down, kept up by Weber. Pushed down back behind the net side of Getz. 6 minutes left in the overtime session. Oh, look out, breakaway coming here. Schwartz with a shot and he missed it. Off the back guard. Weber keeps the puck going, but Davenport comes back for the Bears. Final that comes back up with it. Weber inside the blue line, lost the puck. Comes up down along. Hefner right below our vantage point. Hefner tried playing along with Kleba. 5:25 remaining in overtime. Back down around left side, Kleba. Pushed it back, keeping the zone inside nicely by Rybicki. Now shot, oh, off the mark there. 5:10 remaining in overtime. Still tied at one. Here's Fountain. Shot, pad save made by Getz. Play continues. Getz will cover the puck up and stop play. With just under five remaining, 4:59. In a 1-1 game here in overtime. Shot, oh, almost got it and almost lost it. That could have been the game right there as Getz made the desperation stick save. And we get a penalty call here in overtime against Logan Groff for Fond du Lac. And now the Bears with a golden opportunity to win this thing in overtime on a man advantage power play. Faceoff will come down in the Bears zone right to the left of goaltender Garrett Getz. And before the faceoff, West Bend will take their 1 minute allotted timeout. We are in overtime, 4:53 to go, tied at one. When we come back, the Bears will have a one-man power play advantage. Back here at the Kettle Moraine Ice Arena, we are in overtime, 4:53 to play, 1-1 game, but now the Bears go on a huge power play advantage, and the faceoff coming off to the left side of Getz. Cardinals win the draw, they'll ice the puck all the way back down, and the Bears will come back and reset it up. 1:50 to go now in the power play, 4:40 remaining in overtime. Bears with an opportunity here to end it now on this power play. Kleba lost the puck but gets it back. Lichtensteiger stick handles the puck, takes it to the neutral zone, drops it down, slammed hard into the boards, back down behind the right side of the net. Kept inside by Fountain. And the Cardinals will ice the puck down again off the stick of McGaugh. 1:20 left in the man advantage, 4:10 remaining in overtime. Bears now will try to come back again with 1:08 now to go in the power play and 3:58 to go in the overtime. Skating up ice, Fountain lost the puck again. Missed opportunities right here now for the Bears on this power play. They've yet to get off a shot on goal, and they have 50 seconds left on the power play. Quickly skating up now, Rybicki trying to set something up in the neutral zone, loses the puck. Coming back forward, it's Kleba for the Bears. Kleba up to Rybicki. Rybicki lost it again. 35 seconds left in the man advantage power play. Fondalec penalty killing unit tonight has done a great job not giving up any power play goals tonight. The goal given up was an even Steven goal. 20 seconds left in the man advantage. 3:10 remaining in the overtime. Puck dropped away and the Bears will not be able to get it. So the Bears are 0-5 on power plays. So now we go down to 2:52 remaining in regulation. So now if the Bears want to win it, they'll have to try to do it at even strength. Face off to the left of McGaugh. 2:45 to go in overtime, tied at one. Skating down around, Sable in front of the Fondalec bench. Gives way to Lichtensteiger. 2.5 minutes left in overtime. And now coming up with the puck up ice, skating with it for the Bears. Littke gives way up inside there to Johnson. Skates down behind, 2:15 remaining in overtime. Back down behind the net of Getz. Pickett comes back around on the far board with the puck. 2:05 remaining in overtime. Pickett tries coming up with it to Bublitz. Pumped away, but the Bears still keeping it inside the zone. Whistle stops play with 1:56 remaining in overtime. Faceoff coming down to the left side in the circle to the goaltender Getz. 1:56 to play in overtime. Tied at one. Faceoff draw, shot by Fountain, but the save made by Getz. Faceoff in that same circle. This time the Cardinals win the draw. Coming up, look out, shot and a save. Pushed away nicely by McGaugh. As Schwartz was skating in. Powerful skate in there by Schwartz. McGaugh with the save to keep things alive. Gets set to go back with the faceoff coming up in the circle to the right side of goaltender McGaugh. 1:42 left in overtime, tied at one. Both teams have had a power play opportunity here in the overtime, but neither has been able to push it away. So that's why play continues. Here's Kleba, takes it down inside for the Bears. Try bringing it around and centering the puck. Fountain had time to go with it. 1:20 left in overtime. Push back, up, through, and up. Now coming out center ice again. Schwartz, another chance for a breakaway like he had moments ago. Centers the puck over to Sable, who couldn't quite get it home. 1:05 remaining in overtime. Trying to come back, Lichtensteiger. Dietert keeps the puck inside for the Cardinals. Dietert now at center ice. Dietert drops it down, dropped down. Under a minute to go in overtime. Still tied at one. Now Fountain leads the pack back up to Bechta. Whistle gonna stop us with 37 seconds left in overtime. So each team has had three shots on goal here in the overtime session. Face-off to the right of McGaugh. Bears win the draw. 32 seconds to play in overtime. Pushed it back, coming back now, coming out, it's Weber. Weber with a shot, oh, just to the wide of McGaugh with 20 seconds left in overtime. Greer will set it up again with 14 seconds remaining in overtime. 10 seconds left in overtime. 1-1. Fondelak will try to maybe get one more patch on the goal with 4 seconds left. 3-2-1, that's the end of overtime. Nobody pushes one in and it's still tied 1-1. Shots on goal here in the overtime session. For West Bend, they get 3 shots on goal in the overtime. Fond du Lac gets 4 shots on goal, so total shots on goal right now in the game, 24 for West Bend and 23 for Fond du Lac. Back at the Kettle Moraine Ice Arena, double overtime. The second overtime session now drops down to a 5-minute overtime. Still tied at 1, nobody scored in the first overtime. Both teams had a power play opportunity. Now here comes Fond du Lac with the first attempt at it. Here's Greer, shot and a goal by number 20 Greer in double overtime. Nolan Greer. Nolan Greer gets the goal at the 21-second mark. And Fond du Lac will win this game in double overtime by the final score of 2-1. On behalf of camera operator Tom Stoff, I'm the Bear Barry Hirsch. Thank you for watching this great game tonight of high school hockey on West Bend Community TV. Go Pack, go!